discuss about the statistics. By using the data, we can be able to find the central tendency, that is the middle value of the given data. Here, first of all, we want to know what is data. In early classes, we have already studied about the data. Let just recall about that. The data is a collection of any information, particularly the collection of a particular student's activity, the collection of whole class students' height, marks, the collection of schools' data, schools' information. In generally, it is very useful in the taking the census, right? When we are taking the census, how many are the aged people above 60 and 50 to 60, like this, and then how many are eligible to vote, that is above 18. These are the collection of information from each group, right? And we have studied about that. The data is in two types. One is a ungrouped data. The data is in the two form. One is ungrouped data. Another one is a grouped data. By using this data, we have already studied about that in 9th standard. Finding the central tendency is the main way. For that, the central tendency, here we have the terms. Central tendency, measures of central tendency. We have used the measures of central tendency as the arithmetic mean. First one is arithmetic mean, and then median, and then mode. By using this, the collection of data, by using the collection of data, if you collect the data from your class, whole students, for example, 30 students in the class, means if you arrange the 30 students' height in that class, means we have 120, 130, 140, 142, 121, 131, 132, 142, like this. If you arrange the data up to 30 students, total number of students is, for 30 students, if you arrange the data like this, this data is called a ungrouped data. It is a raw data, right? It is a ungrouped data. So by using this ungrouped data, we cannot be hold the larger data like this. For our convenient to calculate the large data into a, convert the large data into a smaller one, that's why we are finding the arithmetic mean. Arithmetic mean means we are finding the central tendency, right? Central tendency means we are finding the middle value of the given data, or closer to the middle value. Exactly middle value or closer to the middle value is the central tendency. Here we have three methods to find the middle value of the given data. One is arithmetic mean, another one is a median, another one is a mode. Here mode is the number of time it occurs. Number of time it occurs. For arithmetic mean, we use the x bar is equal to sum of the observation divided by number of the observation. Sum of all observation divided by number of observations. Right? So in the, it is general, arithmetic mean is equal to sum of all observation divided by number of observation. In that, it can be rewritten in the form of summation of xi divided by n. N is the number of observation, sum of all the observation, the given observation is, take it as x. So xi means, here I is equal to, summation means up to the nth term, here I is equal to 1 to n is the meaning, right? Here we have 30 means 30 terms, up to the 30. So by using this The bigger, larger data should be converted into a smaller one, like to finding the central value or middle value. By using these three methods, we have studied in the 9th standard. And then in arithmetic mean, we have the grouped data and ungrouped data. In grouped data, we have find the arithmetic mean, or we say call it as a mean also, arithmetic mean or mean. In a grouped data, we have only direct method. We have studied in the 9th standard. In ungrouped data, we have direct method, assumed mean method, and then step deviation method. So these are the method to find the ungrouped and grouped data for finding mean. Here finding mean only. In 9th standard we have studied about it. The x bar is equal to summation xi divided by n is the ungrouped data's mean. For the direct and then assumed and then step deviation method, here we have the deviation. So for grouped method we have the frequencies. For example, the given data is very larger, means we can take the class interval, that is 131 to 140. How many students will be, for example, 10 students, means this is the class interval, this is the frequency. See, 131 to 140, it is a frequency, this is the class interval. By arranging the given data in this form is the grouped data. Here we have the frequency, where we have the frequency is a grouped data, and then we have the formula for direct method, assumed mean method and step deviation method. Here I am going to write the formula for direct method. First one is x bar, we are finding the mean in 9th standard, right? Just we are recalling xi fi divided by summation fi. Here we have frequency, so we have to multiple by the frequency, that is the mean. For the second one, here we have the assumed mean value, so we have the deviation d is equal to xi minus a. D is equal to xi minus a. Here we have the assumed value a, so x bar is equal to a plus summation xi fi divided by summation fi. And then step deviation method, we have the assumed method with the deviation is divided by c. Here I write the step deviation method formula. The deviation d is equal to xi minus a divided by the common term or common class interval. So x bar is equal to a plus summation xi fi divided by summation fi into c. Either we can write it here or here. This is the step deviation method, step deviations mean formula, up to we have studied in the 9th standard. Now we are going to study it about the up to 9th standard we have studied about the central tendency, and then grouped and ungrouped data, we have find out the mean and arithmetic mean or mean or arithmetic mean. Now we have the 10th standard portion, we are going to study about the measures of dispersion. Here we have the measures of dispersion. The dispersion is a measures which gives the idea about the scatteredness of the value. Dispersion means it gives the idea of the scatteredness. Scatteredness are the, we can say it is a measures of variations also. Measures of variation. Variation means difference. That is the, or we can use the word as measures of variation. Here variation means we know the difference. That is the variation. So, for example, let me take it as that students of class 10, students of class 10, right? Here we have 30 students, students of class 10, class 10. Here we have 30 students in that class. So they have scored the marks in one subject, as it is a max, we take it as max. Here we have that one of the students have just passed 45 and then 40, 41, 43, like this, right? 60, 70, 71, 80, 88, 81, 82, 90, 98, 99, same term like this, right? If you arrange the terms, the students have 30 students in the 10th standard, they have scored the marks like this, means it is scattered. See, the variations is between 35 to 100. The difference is between the 35 to 100. In between, we have the scattered. For this, we have selected only the topper students, or below 50 students, means we have the relatively, we have the equal. If you draw that, so 80 to 90 or 90 to 100, if you take this, selected these students, this student's mark is not much of variance differs in between 80 to 90, right? If you draw a scale like this, that 80 to 90 students, the mark scored 80 to 90, means here we have 81, 82, 83 and then 88, like this only, right? But if you select 35, means we have lot of variance, difference between the particular students, right? So here, this data can be finding, this scattered data can be, the spread out data can be finding, is called measures of dispersion or measures of variation. Here we have the different method to, different measures of dispersion. Here we have different measures of dispersions. That's all are one of is range, and then second one is mean deviation, and then third one is quartile deviation, and then fourth one is standard deviation. Fifth one is variance, and then sixth one is coefficients of variation. Variation, VARAH, the coefficient of variation. So we are finding the scattered value, that is 35 to 100 marks that scored, means we have that in between the one of the student 35, another student is 40, 45, like this. It will be increased and some place will be decreased like this, the different students, right? So this will be scattered value. This scattered value is finding is called measures of variations. The same data, if you selected only 80 to 90 students, means here we have the data like this, it is 80 to 90 only, means the data will be like this, not much differs, not much variations like this, right? So one of the students got 88, or 80 to 90 means 81, 82, like this, right? So we have the not difference, lot of difference in this, but here we have that. See, here we have lot of difference in this. If you want to find the measures of variations, means we are finding the scattered values, the variance values, that is called measures of dispersion. Here we have the measures of dispersion to find. We have different method, one is range, another one is mean deviation, and then quartile deviation, standard deviation, variance and coefficient of variance, right? Let's see how we are going to find about this in the next video. Thank you, students.